Excel makes it easy to insert header and footer fields so you can give that final touch to your reports. You just need to know your options and how to get to them. So there are a few ways that you can get to your header and footer options. From your Page Layout tab, you can click on any of these arrows to expand the page setup options and reach the header and footer options from here. You can go to your View tab and select Page Layout. And when you place your cursor inside any of the header and footer sections, you'll see your header and footer menu show up in your ribbon. Or you can go to your Insert tab, and in the text section, select header and footer to jump to the page layout view and the header and footer menu. Regardless of how you get to them, your header and footer are each going to be broken up into three sections. There's a right, center, and left, and can accommodate the same fields. So let's walk through the header and footer menu options. First, if you want each of your tabs to use the same header and footer, you'll save time by having your sheets grouped together while you're adding your header and footers. Just make sure that none of your sheets already contain something in the header or footer, because otherwise this will overwrite anything that's already there. To insert a header or footer message, select the section where you'd like to display your message and simply type your custom message, or you can select from a number of popular options. So if you go to the header and footer menu and look in the header and footer section, so right now we're in header, so I'll click here, you'll see a list of popular options. Now if you use these, so let's say I want to insert the sheet name, just know that the preset will be entered in the center section and will replace any existing header or footer message depending on which one you're in. So you can move it by cutting and pasting it, but then say you try to insert another, so let's do the page number, it will still delete your message and move it back to the center section. So let's delete this. You also have several reference elements you can pick from, and each can provide valuable information for your users. So each of these fields will automatically update. For example, the page number field will reference the number of pages to be printed and will update as this changes. And these you can place where you want and use however many of them you like in a section. You can even intermingle them with other text. For example, say that you insert the page number field here. You can add a space, type of, add another space, and then insert the number of pages field to display the current page in relation to the total number in the document. You can even add more fields below it. For example, press enter and insert the current date just below. You can always toggle back and forth between your header and footer by using the navigation buttons. Otherwise, you could always just scroll up and down your page. You also have options to create a different header or footer for your first page than the rest of your document. So for example, if you check this off and you're on the first page, you'll notice that this label changes to read first page header. So say I put the sheet name in here and scroll down to the second page, that sheet name is missing from here and the label on all subsequent pages changed to just a normal header. And if I uncheck this, of course, that erases my specific first page header. You also have the option to create a different header footer message for odd and even pages. And similarly, you'll see page one is of course an odd number, so the label reads odd page header, and I can insert the sheet name here, then move to any of your even pages. So if I come to page two, now I have the option to set my header for an even page header. And actually here I'll go to the footer, and let's say we want to insert the file path. You can also further personalize your header or footer message by applying some formatting to any of the fields. So to do that, select the field that you'd like to add the formatting to, and in your Home tab, come to the Font section, and here you can change its font color, its font type, the font size. We can bold it, italicize, double underline, and that'll help give it a little bit of a different look. If you want to insert a logo or other image, go to the section where you'd like to place that image, and in the header and footer menu options, select picture, and then select the location where your image is located. Select your image and press insert. So clearly this image is way too big. So I can edit this by clicking on the picture field again, and in the header and footer section, click on format picture. And here in the size tab, making sure that the lock aspect ratio is checked off, I'm gonna resize it to 3/4 inch and press okay. I need to make my margins a little bit bigger. So to do that, you can either select here the top margin and drag down, or go to the page layout tab and set your margins from there. Now you can also add more formatting to this in the format picture section. So say you want to make it grayscale, I can come to the color section, make it grayscale, and click okay. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.